Good afternoon, students. Now in exercise 6.1, sixth problem, we are going to prove. So what we are going to prove here, the area of the quadrilateral ABCD. I am taking ABCD quadrilateral having the diagonals AC and BD. AC and BD is half of AC cross BD. Okay, right. For that, I considered one quadrilateral ABCD. In that we have two triangles, right? So area of quadrilateral here, we can write area of quadrilateral. Area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to, we can write area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ACD. Okay. In vector method, we know how to find area of the triangle. Suppose here we are finding area of quadrilateral ABCD. Area of quadrilateral ABCD equal to area of ABC. Here area of ABC, how to find in vector method? Half of mod AB cross AC. These are two adjacent sides of triangle, no? So half of AB cross AC. Half of AB cross AC will give the area of the triangle ABC. Similarly, for this triangle, area half of AC cross AD. AC cross AD. Right? Now, what I am doing, I want to take AC common. So here AC is first vector, here AC is second vector. So I am interchanging in this two vectors. By interchanging in cross product, you will get minus. If you interchange two vectors in cross product, you will get minus. So AC cross AB. AC cross AB plus 1 by 2 of AC cross AD. Now you can take half AC common. You can take half AC common. I am taking half of AC common. Half of AC common. Right? Half of AC common. Then what you will get here? AB. AB cross. Here like this. AC cross AB plus minus AB. Here minus AB, minus no, minus AB plus AD. Modulus. Half of, now see here, this is AC. Now AB, I am interchanging this to remove the minus. So what you will get? Cross product BA. BA plus AD. BA plus AD. Now that equal to half of AC cross BA plus AD. By adding these two, you will get BD. So what we got? Area of quadrilateral half AC cross BD. Two diagonals of quadrilateral. Right? Now, this is sixth problem. Now seventh problem. Problem number seven. Seventh one. Prove by vector method. Prove by vector method. Vector method. Prove by vector method. The parallelogram on the same base. And between the same. Parallels are equal in area. This is the question, right? So what he is saying? See that the parallelograms on the same base, between the same parallel lines, we are going to show their areas are equal. Okay. Now for that, I will take one diagram here. Suppose I am taking two parallel lines. These are two parallel lines L1 L2. I am denoting this by L1 L2. Suppose I am taking one parallelogram here. This is one parallelogram. I am denoting this vertices as ABCD. This is one parallelogram. In between two parallel lines, with the same base, I am taking another parallelogram here like this. With the same base, here base of this parallelogram is AB. So with the same base, without changing the base, I am taking another parallelogram this side like this. Say this is C dash and E dash. Okay, C dash and E dash. Now we are going to prove that if any two parallelograms lies between two parallel lines with the same base, then their areas are equal. That means we are proving that area of ABCD is equal to area of AB, AB, C dash, D dash. Right? I will take the direction here like this. Okay, if these two are opposite direction, this is passing through intersection point, no? So it will be in this direction. Right, now I'm going what I consider here, like ABCD, ABCD and AB, C dash, D dash, B, two parallelograms, B, two parallelograms, parallelograms, parallelograms on the same base, on the same base AB, on the same base AB, okay, right. Now, we are proving that, to prove area of ABCD, area of ABCD parallelogram equal to area of AB, C dash, D dash. What I am doing, I am taking area of ABC, AB, C dash, D dash first of all, left hand side. Now I am finding area of AB, area of AB, C dash, D dash. I am taking this parallelogram. Area of parallelogram, we know that if you know adjacent sides, then cross product of the two adjacent sides modulus will give the area of the parallelogram, any quadrilateral. Okay, so area of ABCD will be AB cross AD dash, AB cross, AB cross AD dash. This is area of parallelogram. From this formula, we have to derive the area of this formula here, right hand side. That means we have to get AB cross AD, AB cross AD, right? What I am doing here, AB I am keeping as is, why? Because I need AB. Now I need AD, in place of AD dash, we should get AD. So what I am doing here, I am modifying AD dash. How I am modifying AD dash? In place of AD dash, can I write AD plus DD dash? Yes. By adding AD plus DD dash, we can write, we can get AD dash. Now, by splitting this, you will get AB cross AD, AB cross AD plus AB cross, AB cross DD dash, AB cross DD dash. Okay, AB cross DD dash. Now, here AB cross DD dash, see, observe the figure. AB cross DD dash, DD dash, AB, DD dash are parallel vectors. For parallel vectors, cross product will be 0. So, for parallel vectors, these two are parallel vectors. So, this cross product will be 0. So, that implies you will get AB cross, AB cross AD here. AB cross AD, AB cross AD plus 0. Why? Because here you have to write AB is parallel to DD dash. So cross product will be 0. That implies what you will get? AB cross AD. What is AB cross AD in the diagram? It is area of parallelogram, area of parallelogram ABCD. That's all. Okay. Next, 8th question. If G is a centroid of triangle ABC. Triangle ABC. Suppose this is the triangle ABC. This is G. By joining, you will get three triangles. So what we are going to prove here, if G is a centroid of triangle ABC, then prove that area of this small triangle AGB. Area of AGB is equal to area of AGC. AGC that equal to area of BGC. BGC is equal to 1/3 of 1/3 of area of total triangle ABC. Right? Every small triangle area will be the 1/3 of total triangle area. We are going to prove this. Okay? Right? For that solution, and taking G as the centroid. GB is the centroid. Centroid. GB is the centroid. Centroid of triangle ABC. I'm taking GB the centroid of triangle ABC, and I'm taking the position vectors of OA as A bar, OB as B bar, OC as C bar. Then OG equal to A bar plus B bar plus C bar by 3 is OG vector, position vector, OG position vector. Now I am going to take this smaller triangle area, then I will show it is 1/3 of total triangle area, right? Therefore, consider area of triangle AGB. Area of triangle AGB equal to, we know vector area of AGB. Any corresponding adjacent sides of the triangle cross product will give the area of the triangle. So I am taking AB and AG. AB cross AG. Right? AB cross AG. Modulus. Right. Now that equal to C of AB. How we can write OB minus OA? Cross AG. How we can write OG minus OA? Okay. OG minus OA. Now see of OB means B bar. OA means A bar, right? Into OG means what? Position vector of G. So A bar plus B bar plus C bar by 3 minus OA is A bar mod. Okay, right. Now 1/2 of B minus A bar, B minus A bar bracket of, by taking LCM here, A bar plus B bar plus C bar minus 3 A bar by 3. Now see, half of B bar minus A bar, under the bracket B bar plus C bar minus 2 A bar by 3. Now by cross multiplication, by splitting all the terms, what you will get? First to B, with B take cross product. Here cross product, I forgot cross product, it is cross product. Okay, 1/2 of mod B cross B. With B I am taking cross product, B cross B, next to B cross C plus B cross C, right? Next to B minus 2 B cross A, next with me A, minus A cross B, minus A cross C, A cross C, minus of minus plus 2 A cross A by 3. By 3 outside, you will get 1/6. 1/6 of modulus. See here, B cross B is 0. Why? Because both are same vectors. And A cross A is 0. Why? Because both are same vectors. Right? Now, what you will get? Here, this is 0. 0 plus B cross C bar. This is 2B cross A. This is A cross B. Okay. I am interchanging these two vectors. So it will be 2 A cross B. Right? 2 of A cross B minus A cross B minus A cross B minus A cross C minus A cross C. Here A cross A is, will be 0. 1/6 of B cross C. A cross B twice here. One negative term. So you will get plus A cross B plus minus A cross again. 1/6 of 1/6 can I write as 1/3 into 1 by 2. 1 by 2 mod B cross C plus A cross B. I am interchanging this. You will get C cross A. If A bar, B bar, C bar indicates the three sides of the triangle, then this is the formula for area of the triangle. So in place of this, we can write 1 by 3 of area of triangle ABC. In the similar way, we can prove remaining also. Okay,
right.
Now 11th problem. 11th problem is a particle. Acted on by constant force is a i plus 2j minus 6k and another force 6i plus 2j minus 2k is displaced from point 1 2 3 to 5 4 1. Find the total work done by the forces, right? Now this is the question. Now let me solve this problem. Given that solution, we have two forces. Given that F1 is a i plus 2j minus 6k, and F2 is, I'm taking second force as F2, 6i plus 2j minus 2k. These are two forces. Right, and points. One point is 1 2 3. I'm taking as A. Another point is B. I'm taking as B, 5, 4, 1. Now total force. How we can get total force? By adding F1 plus F2. So total force F equal to F1 plus F2. By adding these two forces, what you will get? A i plus 6i, 14i. 2j plus 2j, 4j. Minus 6k minus 2k minus 8k. This is the total force. Now displacement, and denoting by d bar. Displacement equal to ab. Ab, how we can write? Ob minus oa. Ob minus oa. What is ob? Position vector 5i plus 4j plus k. Okay. Minus oa vector I plus 2j plus 3k. 5i minus i, 4i. 4j minus 2j, plus 2j. Plus k minus 3k, minus 2k is the displacement vector. Now from 1 and 2, we can get work done. Work done by force. Therefore, work done by the force is equal to F bar dot D bar. Force vector, total force vector dot d bar. What is total force vector? What we got? Total force vector we got as 49 plus 4j minus 8k. Okay, dot d bar. What we got d bar? 4i plus 2j minus 2k. By dot product, what you will get? 4 4 the 16, 4 1 the 4, 56. 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. So 16 means here you will get 40, 40 plus 8, 48. Sorry, minus no, minus plus no. So total force will be how much? 80 units. Right? 80 units is the total force. Total work done by the force. Okay?
Right.
12th question. Forces of magnitude 5 root 2, 10 root 2 units acting in the direction of 3i plus 4j plus 5k, 10i plus 6j minus 8 respectively. Act on particle which is displaced from the point position vector. This is first point position vector, second point position vector. From this point to this point, there is a displacement. Okay. Now solution. Given vectors, I am taking as a bar, b bar. A bar vector is 3i plus 4j plus 5k. Okay. And b bar is 10i plus 6j minus 8k. Now I am finding the unit vector of a bar. What is the unit vector of a bar? A bar by mod a. So first of all, I need mod a bar. Mod a bar equal to what? 9 plus 16 plus 25. Here mod b. Mod b also I am going to find. Mod b equals 100 plus 36 plus 64. Okay, what you will get? By adding this, you will get 50. 50 that is equal to 5 root 2. 50 we can write 5 root 2. And b bar is, total value is 200. 200 equal to, how we can write? 10 root 2. This is b bar and a bar. Now, I am going to find a cap. A cap is nothing but unit vector. Okay. A cap is nothing but unit vector. A cap is equal to a bar. A bar. What is the formula? A bar by mod a. So, a bar is 3i plus 4j plus 5k by mod a is 5 root. Similarly, b cap. B cap equal to 10i plus 6j minus 8k by again 10 root 2. Okay. Now, I am taking first force vector. First force vector as 5 root 2 a cap. Magnitude is given. This is the direction. So, from this 5 root 2 into 3i plus 4j plus 5k by 5 root 2. So 5 root 2 get cancelled. First force will be here. F1 bar is equal to 3i plus 4j plus 5k. Next second force F2 equal to. F2 equal to what is the magnitude? Given magnitude 10 root 2. 10 root 2 into a cap. B cap. So 10 root 2 into b cap is 10i plus 6j minus 8k. By 10 root 2. 10 root 2, 10 root 2 get cancelled. So F2 bar is equal to 10i plus 6j minus 8. So this is F1 bar, FR. Now I need total force vector. So F1 bar plus F2 bar. By adding F1 plus F2, you will get total force. 3 plus 10i, 39. 4j plus 6j, 10j. 5k minus 8k minus 3k. This is total force. Right, now I am going to find displacement vector. Displacement vector is equal to displacement vector is equal to this moving from first point to another point. Second point is what? 6i plus j minus 3k minus of 4i minus 3j minus 2k. Okay, this is displacement. So by simplifying 2i minus 2j minus k, this is the displacement vector. Now I got displacement vector. Now I am going to find work done by the force. Work done by the force. Work done. Work done by the force. Work done by the force. F equal to, that equal to F bar dot B bar. What is F bar? What we got F bar? We got F bar 39. Plus 10j minus 3k dot d bar is 2i minus 2j minus k. By dot product, what you will get? 26 minus 20 minus half minus plus 3. So 26 minus 20, 6, 6 plus 3. What is 39? 10j minus 3k, 2i plus 4j. Sorry, this is plus 4. Minus j plus yes, this is plus 4j, this is plus 4j. Okay, now 4 tens are 40 here. Plus 40. So 26 plus 40, 69 units. Units is work done by the force. Right.